love of God, stop giving me that lost puppy look.
So, you're speaking to me at least.
Oh, it is always about your needs, isn't it? I have never known a woman with so many needs.
You don't know the first thing about a woman's needs.
How selfish are you? Are you even aware of the price on my head? The pressures I'm under?
If you'd only talk to me, I could help. I want to help you, Dutch, but there's this wall.
You can help by leaving me alone so I can actually think for once.
You're a bastard, Dutch Vanderlind.
Easy.
What the hell's wrong with you all? You hardly said a word.
Just feels like we ain't getting nowhere. It's the end of the century, and seems like we ain't much further on than we was in 65.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe not. We can still live free. We can still say we don't recognize you or answer to your laws. Better to be one man living the truth than a million living a lie. Let me tell you something. Now, you all know that most of us old-timers, we fought alongside each other. 3rd Lemoyne Regiment. the summer of 62. We was hunkered down by Copperhead Landing for weeks. It was a terrible time. It was terrible. Food was rotten. Humidity was unbearable.
We're getting busted, boys!
Don't roll over and die!
Ain't gonna live to tell this tale.
been waiting for you, Arthur.
Well, I'm sorry to have kept you.
Come on, let's get going.
What's the plan?
We're meeting a couple of the Greys over at the saloon. They spoke to Bill about a job needing security.
After the farce of stealing the horses for them, why are we doing this?
Because we need to stay in with them, and they're paying.
So what kind of security they want?
We're about to find out. Now come on.
This seem legit to you, Bill?
Sure. Dutch said we was to keep on dealing with them until we find this gold.
Can we trust them?
Can we trust anyone?
Yeah. Let's just see what they say.
They said there was some big misunderstanding about them horses.
And what about boarding their fields?
They don't know we had anything to do with that.
Oh, that's so.
Yeah. They think it was the Braithwaites. Listen, I know these Grey boys a bit now. This is on the level.
We're stuck in the middle of some ancient feud, but instead of playing both sides, we're being used by both of them.
They were saying the Catherine Braithwaite.
Hey, hold up. This don't feel right.
Now it don't feel right? I could have told you.
Sloppy Morgan.
Do you see that window and Sean's skull? Don't talk to me about that.
Better in here, not there. It's over.
We put down far worse than you, 100 times over. This is the Grays' town. Always has been, always will be.
Only Grays I see left around here is you.
You want us to come out? We'll come out.
Shit. Oh, Bill.
Guns on the ground, now! Both of you, don't do it!
You know we can't do that. You put the gun down, Sheriff!
I'll blow his brains out!
You want to join your little friend there, do you?
Either way, you're a dead man.
always a good kid.
Well, how the hell was I to know?
Let me see. They set us up once before. They didn't like us. We destroyed their farm. Should I go on?
Go easy on him, Morgan.
He was out trying to find a lead. Same as you. Same as Hosea. All you do is complain when things don't work out. Except when it's your goddamn fault.
You don't know what you're talking about. You don't give a damn about nobody but yourself.
Oh, you act so high and mighty, but you're no better than the rest of us. I've ridden with you boys close on, what, 6 months now? And all you ever done was complain. You can fight, but you can't think.
You can't do either.
Okay, cowpoke.
Phil, take the boy's body. Bury him proper someplace, quiet. Micah, best you and I don't speak for a moment.
I'm just so frightened by you.
Get out of my sight, pair of fools. He was like an annoying little brother to me. What fun we had riding together. What a goddamn mess we are making of things.
Yep.
Arthur, have you seen that boy, Jack?
No.
Where's my goddamn son? Where is he? Where's my son? They took him, didn't they? They took my son.
Who took him?
We think the Braithwaite woman took him.
Oh.
But Kieran saw a couple of fellows sound like Braithwaite boys.
Where's my son? If anything, where is my son, Dutch Vanderlyn?
We will find him. We will bring him back to you. And we will kill any fool that had the temerity to touch one hair on that boy's head. Abigail, you have my word.
Just get me back, my son.
I will get that boy back, so help me God. Right now.
Dutch, we just heard about Jack. You need some extra guns?
Yeah, why not? Micah, Kieran, anyone strange turns up, you kill them. Rest of you, let's ride. Okay, let's go get that boy back.
We just got shot to hell by the Greys in town.
I know. I heard about Sean, too. I don't want to even think about that right now. We have to focus on Jack.
I swear, I'll kill everyone there.
Easy, John. Try to stay calm.
I'm fine.
How the hell did they get to him?
I don't know, but we are getting him back, and they will pay. I promise you that.
Somewhere no one knows.
What?
I've turned every stone.
Christ's sake, Hosea. After all that, another perfect scam.
We underestimated them.
No, they underestimated us. Enough talk. There is no point arguing how we got here. This is where we are. And we are going to fix it. So come on!
First Sean, now Jack. We should have stayed out of all of this.
Bit late for that, ain't it?
Quiet. We're going to fix this right now.
Like they don't know we're coming.
Come on, let's get this done. John, you sure you're okay?
Like I said, I'm fine.
Follow my lead. Both these redneck families think they can ruin us? I don't think so.
There they are.
Who steals a goddamn boy?
I'm gonna let fly at those sons of bitches!
Don, I need you to stay calm. Get down here now, you inbred trash!
Easy, John.
We've come for the boy. You must have known we would.
Shouldn't have messed with our business now, should you?
Whatever complaint you have with us, alleged or otherwise, that is a young boy. That is not the way you do things. Hand him over.
Get the hell off our land.
If you ain't gonna be civilized about this.
Stop it.
get out there. We got this door covered.
This must be it! I can't see a goddamn thing! One, two, three!
Where's the boy?
We have lived in this house for 120 years. We never had no problems except for
Yankees. Where is the boy? Who took him?
You killed my son!
Oh, and I will surely kill the rest of them unless you start talking.
Oh, I know your type. Common scum.
Where is the boy?
You filth.
All right. Get her out of here.
What about down?
Now let's get this hag outside. Any more of her sons to deal with?
I reckon they're all dead.
That's right. Burn this dump to the ground. You boys sure Jack ain't in here?
We searched everywhere, Dutch.
You got that one, Arthur?
I guess that's the end of the goddamn cribbage game.
Come here!
Never liked you.
Why'd you take the boy, Mrs. Braithwaite?
You stole
my boys are off limits.
You stole my horses. Ain't no rules in war, Mr.
Matthews.
Yes, yes, that's it.
Where's the boy?
My sons gave him to Angelo Bronte. So my guess is Saint-Denis. Either there. We're on the boat to Italy.
Let's go.
Arthur, come on.
What are we doing with her?
Leave her.
I told you she was crazy.
Come on.
It's gonna work out, John. It's gonna work out. Listen to Dutch.
Now, I don't expect you to understand this, but I have never been more proud of you than I am right now, brother. You're doing the right thing.
If I don't get that boy back safe, she'll kill us all.
I know, but looking at this logically, well, that boy is fine. They took him to scare us. Nobody takes a boy to harm him.
He's right, John.
What do you think, Arthur?
The boy will be fine. But, well, of course, Marston's scared rotten. We killed all those people. We stirred up all that trouble. For nothing.
No. No. Not for nothing. For living. Now, we get that boy back, and we go. Trust me.
Hey, Dutch, we got a problem.
Not a problem. Visitors. A solution. Good day, fine people. Mr. Vanderlinde, Mr. Matthews, I presume. And who are you?
Rip Van Winkle.
Huh. Good day, sir. Agent Milton, Pinkerton Detective Agency. Agent Ross. Ah, Mr. Morgan, nice to see you again.
And to what do we owe the pleasure, Agent Moron?
I don't know if you're aware, but this is a civilized land now. We didn't kill all them savages only to allow the likes of you to act like human dignity and basic decency was outmoded or not yet invented. This thing, it's done.
This place ain't no such thing as civilized. It's man, so in love with greed, he has forgotten himself and found only appetites.
And as a consequence, that lets you take what you please, kill whom you please, and hang the rest of us? Who made you the messiah to these lost souls you've led so horribly astray?
I'm nothing but a seeker, Mr. Milton.
You ain't much of anything more than a killer, Mr. Vanderlinde. But I came to make a deal. It's time. You come with me, and I give the rest of you 3 days to run off, disappear, and go and live like human beings someplace else.
You came for me? Risk life and limb in this den of lowlifes and murderers so that they might live and love? Ain't that fine?
I don't want to kill all these folk, Dutch. Just you.
In that case, it'll be my honor to join you. Excuse me, friends. I have an appointment to keep with.
I think your new friend should leave now, Dutch.
You're making a big mistake, all of you.
Yeah, dreadful. We have got something. Something to live and die for. How awful for us. Mr. Milton, stop following us. We'll be gone soon.
I'm afraid I can't. And when I return, I'll be with 50 men. All of you will die. Run away from this place, you fools! Run!
Come on.
Get your damn hands off of me, boy.
What now?
We get out of here. And quick. Any ideas?
I know a big old house, hidden in the swamps outside Saint Denis. I'm sure they'll find us eventually, but it should buy us a few days.
A few days is all we need.
There's a spot out by Shady Bell. Lenny and I got into that dispute with the previous occupiers. Place is well hidden.
You and Arthur, ride out to make sure no one else has moved in. Lenny, go follow those fools out of here. Make sure that they leave. And John, we'll get Jack back, and we'll get going. Rest of you, get packing!
Come on, John.
This is crazy.
We'll get packed up, but we need a new spot.
Follow me. I know the way. It's gonna be all right, John.
We should be going for Jack.
We will. We have to move everyone first before that bastard Milton comes back with an army. We ain't no use to Jack in jail or at the end of a rope.
I don't even know what to think no more.
Just gotta keep our cool. smart about this.
Smart? Are you joking? You make too much noise once again. We drew him right to us. I mean, how many people we killed the past few weeks?
Far too many.
It's Dutch playing his games. Hosea, too. Getting involved with those two families. Master con men working their magic.
They thought there was a lot of gold.
Yeah, they thought there was money. Ain't there always?
Look, Marston, I don't know what to tell you. Things don't always work out. That ain't nothing new.
Jack's gone. We lost Sean, Mac, Davey, Jenny. And for what?
We can't change what's done. We can only move on.
But one day, we need to start learning from our mistakes.
Come on, it ain't all bad. We've had a rocky run. We'll be okay. We'll get through it.
Dutch will fix it. Dutch will come up with a big plan. Right now, every plan gets us into worse trouble. We're getting further from where we're meant to be going.
Now, you can't put all this on Dutch. You're worked up, and rightly so. Just don't get too far in your head with all this, or you'll never get out.
It's a goddamn mess. That poor kid. We chose this life. He didn't.
I don't know. I think this life chose us.
You, me, Dutch, Hosea. It's been a long time now.
Sure has. Lots changed.
I sometimes wonder if things was ever the way we remembered them. If we were ever who we thought we was.
Like I told you, don't go down a rabbit hole with this, Marston. That won't help nothing.
I treated Jack bad. Abigail, too. I didn't want to believe he was mine. You know, when I was lost on that mountain after Blackwater, part of me thought...
All right. Should be just down this path to the left here.
Now, I was saying, I could just leave again and no one would ever know.
But some wolves thought otherwise. Look, you're here now. And this spot we're going to, it's close to Saint Denis. Soon as we get the others safe, we'll find this Bronte and get Jack back.
So what is this place?
Lenny found it. Big old run-down plantation house. That's it up ahead.
Four walls and a roof. We're moving up in the world.
You ain't seen inside it yet.
Come on. Sooner we get this done, the better. Whoa! You sure this place is empty?
I ain't sure on nothing.
All right. Let's leave the horses here and take a look.
Oh, shit! It's them again! Boys! Get ready!
Oh, damn it. Still some here.
I can see that. You think there's more of them?
I'll check the house. You keep watch out here.
You pay for every life you took.
Sorry, boys, this is ours now.
God! Oh, shit!
Anymore of you upstairs, I'm coming for you. You hear me?
Come on. I got a bullet here waiting for you.
You fools should have left when you had the chance.
Where are you creeps hiding? Come out where I can shoot you.
Tough guy. Message last time.
Get the hell off our
can still walk out of here. Today.
This is what I signed up for.
I knew you'd come soon enough. You are some of the coward, like you. The bounty hunters, the feed men, the cup, carpet baggers. The army of criminals who stole our land and our government. I survived them all. Our fight will live on.
Jesus.
How's it looking up there?
I think that's a lot. Didn't even have to shoot the last one.
Good. Come help me with this, please. Coming! Here, give me a hand moving these bodies. Don't want the others walking into this. Me. All right, this way. We'll dump the bodies in the swamp over there.
Okay, I can deal with the rest of the bodies. You go meet up with the caravan. Guy in a minute. We got fine living. And all the corpses and the alligators, it's paradise. I love it.
Miss Grimshaw, Mr. Pearson, would you two kindly work your magic? Arthur, take a ride with me.
Sure.
Come on.
George?
Yes?
Could I have a word with you?
Not now. Come on, Arthur. Can you believe that girl? All I've got going on, and she wants to talk.
Everything okay with you two?
I got far more important things to worry about right now than Molly O'Shea.
So, where are we going?
To take a look at this eighth wonder of the civilized world, Saint-Denis, I keep hearing about. According to the map, the road up this way should lead us right in there.
All right. I guess this day ain't over yet.
Not quite. Good work back there, Arthur. Everything went okay?
Few loose ends. Nothing major.
And John?
About what you'd expect. He's taking it hard.
We are going to get that boy back, whatever it takes. I need you to start asking around in the city for Bronte. Subtly, of course. Public places, maybe start with the saloons. Anyone who can put us in contact with him.
Of course. What about the Pinkertons?
I'm fairly sure nobody followed us. We moved out fast. We should be safe for a few days here.
And then?
I think we need to move a little further. Put some ocean between us and all of this. The mess with those two families, losing Sean. I see things differently now. For a long time, I truly believed a paradise lay somewhere in the West for us. But I just don't know anymore.
So we're leaving the country now?
Maybe. I'm still thinking about it. Whatever we do, we'll need more money. In any case, we have more pressing matters to attend to first. Okay, there she is. A real city. The future.
Big cities. They're
always repellent.
Exactly.
I'll find you in there. Go see what you can figure out.
Yes.
That's a fine steed. Got some stable space for rent, if you're interested. I know a lot of my breeders personally. Best stock, guaranteed. I can't tell you how many times I use that one. That's the same one I use, too. You know, a horse can tell when you're using a cheaper saddle. High quality, keep it simple. You won't go wrong. a fancy streak, huh? Be sure to let everyone know where you got this nag groomed.
Transport, sir.
Got a train pulling into the station real soon. Hello there and welcome. Liberty is worth every penny.
I know.
Best meat's here.
Okay,
best
then.
Hey, look out! Come on, the hell's the matter with you? Thought you was tough.
Hello there. Welcome to Horner & Co. Got my candies in the middle there, tobacco in the corner, food and sundries to the sides, and the booze is up by the counter. You want the full range? Just have a look through the catalog. Lot more in there than what you see on the shelves. All right.
And that should be good.
Have a good one.
Evening.
Bonjour, ma chère.
Excuse me, partner.
Evening, partner.
Hey, ma'am.
Evening to you.
Hey, mister.
Good evening.
Good evening to you.
Evening.
Evening, sir.
Yes. Hey, partner.
Wait, little man.
Good evening, mister.
Hey, friend. Just shut up. You don't know me.
It's all right.
Good evening.
Evening, mister.
I'm new in town. Supposed to be meeting a man called Angelo Bronte. Any idea where I might find him?
Not in here, that's for sure. If he wants to drink anywhere, it would be the Bastille Saloon opposite the park with the Quincy Harris statue.
Appreciate it.
Just watch yourself. He's got quite the reputation.
I'm looking for a man called Bronte. You heard of him?
Don't know who you're talking about.
Okay, never mind.
Like I said, can't help you.
Excuse me.
Hello?
You should get up, my friend. You're missing all the fun here.
Bye.
Hey, let me see that ugly mug.
Stick 'em up, cowboy.
Yeah, real funny, Dutch.
Oh, I thought so. So, here we are in a strange land of papists and rapists. America's very own Gomorrah.
This city's all of the same to me. So, how you get on?
I've been asking around about Mr. Bronte. And from what I've heard, this establishment is our best lead. But I haven't had any joy in there so far.
So, I should just give it a shot?
I think so. Just keep it cool.
You know me?
I'll meet you back here anon.
Hmm.
Funny you should say that.
Well, you know how it is. I told him. I said,
excuse me.
Peter LeMoyne for you. America's dirty little French secret.
That's why we love
hey,
it.
Can Born I get a drink here?
I'm sorry. Please excuse me. I seem to have some very impatient customers. Now, how can I help? You look like a whiskey man.
Sure.
Dollar, please.
For a whiskey?
Oh, that's the real stuff. From Scotland.
Okay. Here, have one for yourself.
Well, thank you.
So, mister, can I ask you a question? You ever hear of a fella by the name of Bronte?
Who's asking?
Me. I'm asking.
No, leave it, friend.
What do you mean, leave it?
Look, I don't know what business you in, but leave it, friend. You and your pal that was in here before.
Bronte?
Angelo Bronte.
Mr. Big. Mr. Italian spaghetti-eating long streak of piss big. He makes my skin crawl. I'm so squally a cocksucker. You know what I mean, friend?
Where can I find him?
Oh, well, I reckon you talk to them kids in the alley. They'll know, I guess. Oh, and friend? You be careful now. Immigrants, they're not to be trusted.
Hello?
What do you want?
Morning to you, mister.
Buenos dias.
You, mister, excuse me.
Come on now, this sulking doesn't become you.
You always have to be right, don't you?
I'm just giving you the correct use of the word. If you're feeling sick, you're not nauseous, you're nauseated.
Right, you're nauseous and I'm nauseated.
You're impossible.
Hey! Hey, you got a cigarette, mister?
Maybe.
Huh?
I'm looking for a fellow named Angelo Bronte, Italian.
I know him. Everyone knows him.
Where is he?
We'll take you to him. What it'll cost?
I reckon I can pay.
$5.
Where does he live? New York?
I'm an entrepreneur. If you don't want to pay, then I don't want to walk.
Oh, man. That's a bad breath. Here. Come on.
This away. Let's go, mister. You coming, Cleet? Stay close. Easy to get lost around here. Come on, then. You new to the city, mister?
Pretty much.
Don't worry. No one knows it as good as me and Cleet.
Is that right?
Hope you won't need his services, but you got the doctor on the corner there. Nice enough, fella. That's Baird and Schreiber on the right there. Famous bookstore. Not that I'm much of a reader myself. Now over here's a real piece of art. That's the Church of the Holy Blessed Virgin, mister. Modeled on the famous church in Toulouse, which is in France. You been to Toulouse, mister?
No.
We're Catholics here, mister. Ain't Baptist or nothing.
My mama said they used to burn Protestants and all, but,
Bet they don't have nothing so fine where you come from, mister. Look at them fine steeples.
Hey, hey, you little pair of shits!
Let's go! That fellow looks angry!
Get back here!
Kid, that
lot of shit went that way.
Thanks for the help, friend.
You know, I kind of miss old Bob Taylor.
I am.
Hey, you see a kid about 14 years old run through here?
Why, yes, we did. He went around the corner there.
Thanks a lot, mister.
That's enough. Come here.
Hey! Moron!
Hi, mister.
Honey, I feel sorry for you.
Sure glad that ain't me. I'll spend it on something nice, mister, I promise.
You give that back!
You ain't got a chance in hell, Slowpoke.
I'll kill you, thieving bastard.
Just give it up, farm boy. You're making a fool of yourself.
Just give it up, kid.
My little fool.
Bueno.
Hey there.
I'm telling you, a cucumber's definitely a fruit.
Since when?
Hi there, ma'am.
Good morning, sir.
So it must be true.
Can't beat this weather.
The sun seems to put everyone else in a better mood.
This is fun, mister. I like you.
What's the problem, Fred?
Give me my things, boy.
What are you talking about, friend?
I ain't your friend, but that kid is, and he robbed from me. Now give me back my stuff and take me to Angelo Bronte.
Senor Bronte.
That kid was gonna show me before he robbed me. Now, come on.
You new in town, mister?
Come on.
Mr. Bronte's got a lot of friends, mister, but I ain't never seen you.
We ain't friends.
You don't like no one, mister. Mr. Bronte, he's got fine hair. He got a beautiful house, and I am proud to work for him. He got 50 men, mister. Why he gonna care a thing about you?
I just want to speak with him.
I'm sure you do, mister. You and them friends of yours been asking about him all over town. He's been mighty disrespected. Bunch of muddy Yankees in town asking questions. Well, you and your friend should pay him a visit, mister. He's got a big house on Flavian Street opposite the park.
Hey, yokel.
Now, get out of here.
Please, a coin?
Go get yourself something to eat.
Sir, I want you to have this.
Thanks, friend.
It's nice to give something instead of just begging.
Morning.
Good morning, friend. Pay attention.
Hello, sir.
Be careful.
How's your name?
Morning, mister.
Buongiorno.
Hey, kitty. Morning.
Morning, my friend.
you been?
Getting robbed?
Who by?
Bunch of children.
I won't inquire anymore.
But I found Mr. Bronte. Seems to be some Italian Mr. Big in town. Everybody knows him, but nobody wants to talk about him. Apparently lives in a big house on Flavian Street, opposite the park. Huh.
Good work.
So what now?
We go pay him a visit. I'll get John, you meet us there. Whatever it takes, we need to get that boy back.
I cannot decide which I like less, the swamps or the city. Both are full of parasites, reptiles, and slime. We're a long way east of land we know, and far from real open country. Hey, fellas.
Mister.
Morning, hello. Friend.
Morning, sir.
Say what you want about the people around here. They're friendly. Good morning, mister.
Whoa, look out!
Xin-san.
Jou-san.
Let's get you looking nice. Morning, sir. Ma'am.
Morning.
Oh, come on.
Hello,
mister. Hi there, mister.
Morning, fella.
Decent town you got here.
Yeah.
Pardon.
Apologies. Hi there.
Morning, sir.
You seem full of joys of spring, miss.
You need help in the head or something?
Put
you in your place,
please. Hello, gentlemen.
Morning to you.
Hello.
Howdy.
Joe-san.
Look out.
I'm just in a friendly mood today for some reason.
Come a hold on.
Sure, what you want?
Brandy.
Two brandies, bud.
It's $2 a glass.
Oh, better be good then. Mm.
It's the best. Oh. Thank you. Santé. It's quite a country you're building here, eh?
Well, me personally?
I don't know. What do you do?
Mostly, I just shoot people.
How very American of you. I love it.
What do you do?
Oh, mostly I pose, I show off, I complain.
Oh, how very French.
I know. I am ridiculous. I have been all over the world. I have seen the sights, and I have discovered the one eternal truth that I am a pies, how do you say, all ass.
Asshole.
That too. That too!
Well, at least you have some self-knowledge. Where were you on your journey?
All the civilized world. Painting my little pictures, meeting the locals, you know.
You a painter?
No, I'm a holas. I thought we had covered this.
Yeah, but you paint.
Not according to salons at Paris. No, according to them, I cannot draw, I cannot paint, and I should go away. And so I went away.
You miss Paris?
That smelly, filthy place with old buildings and ghosts and shit and French people. I have that right here.
I guess so.
You know,
Arthur.
Charles. You know, Arthur, don't believe in art. It's lies. Believe in women. They're the truth. Art is lies, but the vagina, that is truth. Breasts is truth. Art. For it is.
If you say so.
Oh, trust me, I've tried both. One is better. Much better. So, I must be boring you. But here.
What is it?
It's just a little doodle. You know, entirely worthless unless you want to wipe your bottom with it. But I wanted to say thank you for the drinks.
Well, that's very kind, Charles.
No matter.
Good meeting you.
Welcome, sir.
Watch yourself.
Oh, pardon me, sir.
Sweet Jesus,
son of a bitch.
Hey, he just picked your pocket. Go. Go after him.
I think you have me mistaken, sir.
Excuse me.
Give me the money, now.
Oh, shit.
Sorry. I'm sorry.
Get a move on.
I'm sorry. All right, here. It'll never happen again. I swear.
Let's have a look in here.
I hope this store will bring more people to Chinatown, but I am still waiting.
That should be good.
Tell me if you want to try one out.
Got what I need. Thank you for your help.
Hello, sir.
Hey, mister.
Hello, sir.
Hey, mister.
Hey.
Hey, partner.
How are you keeping?
You must need eyes in the back of your head.
Uh-huh.
Anyway. I won't disturb you any longer.
So long.
Officer, how are you?
Excuse Hello, mister. You.
Play home.
Ma'am?
Hello,
hey, partner. Hey, friend.
Senor.
Hey there.
Mister.
Read one of my pamphlets. I explain the exact difference between the races using real science.
I want you to ask yourself, do I consider myself pure? And then I want you to ask yourself, what is the most disgusting, revolting, vulgar, and depressing thing in all creation? Mingling. Co-mingling. Nature. Nature likes purity. Nature does not like co-mingling. Nature likes a family tree, not a family bush. And this being America, and us being nature's paradise on Earth,
hello,
we must push for purity. I want you, I need you, to be pure.
Hey, cat. Barner?
You, sir, do you want a pamphlet?
You can have it go the way you hoped to, do you?
That happens time to time.
Okay.
Read it. It's really interesting stuff. I explain, using real science, why we whites are under attack, and what we must do to fight back.
Under attack?
Yes, under attack. People aren't the same, sir. I mean, white people are the same. And all the other races are trying to kill us. I don't want to die, sir.
I got friends who's Mexican, friends who's Indian, known blacks, Irish, Italians, good and bad and all. I've known good white people and bad white people. And above all, dumb white people.
You, sir, are a real fool. How can you possibly believe in equality? I've never heard such nonsense in all my natural born days. This man believes people are equal. Speak for yourself, sir. Speak for yourself.
I'm sorry. You just call me a fool?
A fool! A fool! A fool!
Come here!
Someone help me! Oh, no!
Hey, move it!
Careful how you move now.
God damn it! Don't! I'm asking you man to man! This is what they want, us turning on each other. Oh my God!
Go away! This is the end for you!
Put this bastard down.
Wasn't the blues. We were storing powder here.
Get down to cover now!
Well, look at whose path is crossing again.
Thank you.
Hello, mister.
Listen, have you seen... I'm looking for my friend, Gavin.
I don't know any Gavins, I'm afraid.
English bloke. Lovely fella. He went missing, and now I'm all alone.
Good luck.
That's too bad.
Gavin!
Damnation, that just about turned my gut.
This is just too bad.
Hello, sir. Gentlemen, hello.
How do you do, sir?
Hi, folks.
Why, hello there, sir.
Hey there.
Well, hello.
Hello, sirs.
I can't.
Hey there, partner.
Show your face.
Hello there. That's so.
I thought I recognized you. Hello again. Oh my, you are a bad person. Farewell.
How's your luck?
I have not been good at all, unfortunately.
Wait your turn. Almost done.
Well, hello again. I got another one then. You interested?
How's things, Alden?
Good. All right. This is a little different. Take the coach and deliver it to my contact. He'll pay you well for it. It's a fragile cargo, so go easy.
Okay. But the money best be right.
Oh, it is. Sir? I promise, it's very right.
Hello.
I do apologize.
Not good. Oh, sorry.
Well, thank God for that.
Hello.
How do you do?
Hello there.
Hey, it's good to see you again, friend. But what you doing here?
Just visiting old friends, I guess.
Well, you better get out of here. There's a bunch of government agents I met asking about you all across town. Yeah, them and a bunch of bounty hunters, too, I think.
So?
Yeah. Yeah, but you don't seem too scared.
Yes, not.
Well, they seem pretty mad. What'd you do?
Nothing good.
Well, you better get out of here.
You better watch your behavior around here.
Sorry, there must be some mistake. Listen, you won't get no trouble out of me. So, don't worry.
Bye now.
Leaving me, huh?
Sure.
Yeah, well, leave this then.
What you fools up to?
It's Mr. Black's fault.
His fault, the darky white. Although, I don't know why they call him that. Look at him.
Don't you start now.
I'll knock the color clean off you. Come on.
And I'll tell you, you lily livered.
Enough. You two fools look like you've just run off a chain gang.
Yeah, what of it?
What are you doing?
Starving.
They got bounty posters for us all over town.
And we can't go into town to get supplies.
Say, mister, maybe you can do us fools a favor. We ain't bad guys at all. He's okay, even for a darkie.
Shut it, you pasty-faced streak of piss!
Yeah, I had up to here with you.
Enough! Do you a goddamn favor, what you want?
Maybe you can go into town and take down them wanted posters of us.
Okay.
Maybe meet us back at the campfire in the woods and tell us how you did.
Maybe bring us a little bite to eat.
Don't push your luck.
Nice fella.
Yeah, you love nice fellas.
Don't you start up again. Just shut up.
You shut up!
Hey, I need to get to that poster behind you. Would you move a little?
Good evening, sir.
I will not. Deputy put up plenty. Go get one of those.
Hey, move. I need that poster.
Oh, I'll move, all right. How's this for moving? This what you...
Have this!
You...
What?
You ain't...
Bounty.
You ain't my...
No... No damn manners.
Cut that man... Oh, you are going down.
As you made out.
Hey, mister.
Bad, they worse than worse.
That all?
You always was one for gossip. Jethro Minglethorpe. Gossip, gossip, gossip. But as usual,
got posters all over town if you'd like to help.
Howdy, Sheriff.
But the darkie killed a white man.
Jimmy Holdacre had a weak heart. He died of a heart attack.
Nonsense.
And Samson Black was set up.
Just minding my business.
Couple fellers missing. Got posters up all over town.
Mister, I need that poster. There's been a recall.
I weren't born yesterday. This one's mine, so you can go and get your own.
Been better, I suppose.
No,
hello, sir.
New in town?
Just being nice.
What can I get for you?
I have, whatever you like.
Careful,
that's yours,
man.
No.
Seen you in here before. You new to town? Well, roads ain't what it used to be. Not for some time now. Ain't sure if you heard of the Gray family already.
You're in my spot.
Show me something.
Now get.
Oh, just no get out of my way. More.
Excuse me.
Don't pretend otherwise. Excuse me.
It's a stupid thing to do.
What's the problem with you all? We're trying to make this country something again. Lousy drunk. Pathetic, the lot of it. Hey, can I get some service? What do you boys need? Move along. We ain't looking for your company.
All right, simmer down.
I'm gonna hit the trail. Come on.
I'll stand.
Hey now, you're gonna leave here. You got me?
Okay. You don't leave, I'll make you leave. That's simple.
Look
out.
Why can't you write us leaving at the door? Please, fellas. You're already dead. The COD sends it to you.
Tony Batman is a disgrace.
All right. What do I have you for?
Great God.
What in tarnation?
My God.
How many?
I'll kill you!
Oh, my.
Hey, mister.
How do you do?
I can't believe you would show me your face.
Can I trust you in a ride, partner? Can you give me a ride?
Where's the wind taking us today?
Saint Denis, please.
I'll have you there faster than a cat on a mouse.